Hey everybody, welcome to another edition of OVW Mania here on Triple Threat Talk. Now this video is for episode 120. It is probably the second one you're seeing because Big B didn't realize I was going to have a video last week and he left it off the show. So hopefully he aired the first video before this one so that you're caught up and you kind of know what's going on in the OVW world. And I'll be going over that in just a moment. But first, I was hoping that I would be coming to you as a fan of the National League champion St. Louis Cardinals. They're still one win away from the World Series and being the National League champions, but they do have a 3-2 lead at this point over the Dodgers, and I think we can do it, but we've got to wait till Friday, October 18th now for Game 6 back at Busch Stadium. We can do it, right, Yachty? Yeah, that's what I thought. So that's coming soon, but getting back to OVW, we're going to talk about the latest episode that was filmed Wednesday, October 16th at the Davis Arena. It was episode 739. Don't forget all the dark matches. They had four that happened before the show because of the cage match. You can check out all the results from those at ovwmania.blogspot.com. As for the main show, it was kind of a short show as far as the number of matches they had, but they were big matches and they took up a lot of time. So the show started off with the first match of the Best of Three series for the OVW Southern Tag Team titles between the best team ever of Jesse Godders and Rudy Switchblade and their opponents, the champions, Muhammad Ali Vaez and Michael Hayes. Before the match could even get started, the Furians, Rob Terry and Marcus Anthony, came to the ring and they said that they wanted their tag title match now because they're number one contenders and they won the Nightmare Cup. Michael Hayes said that they waited too long to get their stuff together, so they're just going to have to wait for their opportunity. And Jesse Godder said that this was the best team ever show and that they needed to go eat a steak or something because it was their time to shine. So the Furians left the ring, and we had a very good back-and-forth match between the two teams. In the end, Ali is double super-kicked out of the ring by Rudy and Jesse, and then they hit their finisher, the best finisher ever, on Michael Hayes, to score the first victory in the Best of Three series, which gives them, you know, quite an advantage. So they have a good opportunity to become the tag champions with just one more win. However, after the match, the Furians return to the ring and destroy all four men, including hitting a massive power slam on Jesse Godders where he had to be helped from the ring. After that, Jamin Olivencia came to the ring, and he said that he was in a bad mood, even though the fans were making him feel a whole lot better. He said that he wanted some answers from Johnny Spade as far as why he attacked him, why he aligned himself with the scumbag Timmy Danger. Timmy Danger comes rolling through the curtain in his wheelchair again with Spade close behind. And they get in the ring, and Spade says that he's been hearing all this stuff about Jamin being the longest reigning OVW heavyweight champion in history. And he says the only reason that's so is because he's been out with an injury and had surgery. He said if he was there, he would have already taken the title away from Jamin, and he wouldn't have had to listen to any of this. He said, plus, if you remember in history, he said that he has fought and beat Jamin three times, including last September in a 30-minute Ironman match. And Jamin says that Spade sounds jealous, says that, that he doesn't really deserve a shot. And Johnny Spade says he understands. He goes, he knows Jamin's a family man, and he said that Jamin is probably ashamed that he would have to go back to his family and explain to them why he lost to Johnny Spade a fourth time. Jamin starts going after Spade, but Timmy Danger gets in the middle and grabs Jamin's arm to distract him, and that momentary distraction allows Johnny Spade to hit Jamin with another super kick to lay him out. Johnny stands over him and holds up the OVW heavyweight title to end that. Then they set up the cage during intermission, and that was our big main event. Like I said, it was a kind of a short show. After they set up the cage, they show some interviews in the back with the Shiloh Jones and the Pope, Elijah Burke. Then we have our cage match. Now, at the very beginning, the Marauders were sent to the back, even though they couldn't get in the cage necessarily anyway. But the Pope starts off early with some good offense. Shiloh comes back. Pope makes a comeback. Actually kicks Shiloh off as they're fighting, you know, around the top of the cage. And when Shiloh falls, he falls down on top of Chris Sharp and takes out Chris Sharp. Then Pope, instead of going on and climbing out, stands on top of the cage and leaps from the top of the cage down on Shiloh in an incredible moment. Then Pope tries to climb out of the cage again, but the Marauders run back out to the ring, surround the ring. He has to try to keep knocking and kicking them off the cage to keep from getting in and interfering. Meanwhile, the masked Marauder that's been with him makes referee Josh Ashcraft, who was out on the outside in charge of the door, makes him unlock the door so he can slide in a steel chair to Shiloh. And Shiloh hits Pope in the back twice with the steel chair and then across the head. And Chris Sharp comes back too, and Shiloh is then able to get the pin and keep the OVW television title thanks to the outside interference. Now, after the show, I'm assuming this part wasn't on TV, the Marauders sent Nick Dumeier back in the ring to get the handcuffs that Joe Coleman wears around his neck, and Pope gets back up and has Ashcraft lock the door and goes to town on Dumeier with the steel chair, which the Marauders just leave Dumeier for dead and go on to the back during all this. Then Pope leaves the ring and grabs the mic and gets on top of the announce table, and he says that it gets harder every time. He's very emotional. He says, but this is the third time now he's leaving OVW. He said that OVW's always home, that Danny Davis gave him a great opportunity 10 years ago, and he's been able to travel all over the world. He said, but he's going to be gone. He said, now, he will be gone for a while. He said, but he won't be gone forever. And he said that OVW will always be home, that he loves each and every single one of the fans, and to remember that the Pope is pimping. So that was the show. Even though it was basically two matches in the segment with Jamin and Spade, it was still a very good show. I would definitely recommend watching it if you haven't already by the time you view this Triple Threat Talk episode. And that's pretty much it. I wanted to try to keep it short and sweet because this is probably, like I said, the second video you're watching of OVW Mania this week. So without further ado, I'm going to send it back to the guys in the studio. Have a great week, and we'll talk to you again next time.